Thursday, May 2004. Thursday, May the 20th, 2004.
I'd like to call this meeting to order. Appreciate you being here. Appreciate the fellowship and the friendship and the sharing together this morning. Before we turn this meeting over to Brother Massengill to speak to you members of the board, the elders, we've asked Brother Webb if he'd do the roll call.
Roll call, members of the executive committee, Reverend Lonnie Light, General Overseer.
Present.
Reverend Jim Cox, Assistant General Overseer.
Present.
Reverend Michael Padgett, Assistant General Secretary and Treasurer.
Present.
Reverend Cornelius, Dave Cornelius, member of the Elder Board.
Present.
Reverend Jerome Walden, member of the Elder Board.
Present.
Reverend Wayne Eisen,
present.
Elder Board. Reverend Fred Cornelius,
present.
Member of the Elder Board. Reverend Henry Taylor.
Present.
Reverend Cecil Johnson.
Present.
Reverend Jim Kilgore.
Present.
Reverend Mike Cornelius.
Present.
Reverend Ray Landis, Jr.
Present.
Reverend Donnie Hill.
Present.
Brother Ken Massengill, member of the Finance Committee.
Chairman, Reverend Ken Massengill to speak to you. This meeting was called because of a follow-up meeting needed from the Finance Committee meeting of May the 11th. Brother Massengill. All right, you heard a report by the Finance Committee Chairman. Before we go any further, I would like to ask our other two members of the Finance Committee, Brother Landis and Brother Cornelius, if Brother Massengill's report was correct, and do you have anything to add to it?
I feel Brother Massengill's report is correct as to the meeting that took place last Tuesday. And I don't mind to tell you that I had already stated in that private session that I wasn't going to sign an affidavit to verify every figure in the 2002 minute book. Because I never saw every CD, I never saw every figure. I said what we all said that what we could do is verify that the figures that you see is what was reported, you know, and so they were reported as such, and that's, we verify that. But I couldn't.
I would like to respond to Dave Cornelius' statement. Brother Cornelius, if you were coming to the office of the General Secretary and Treasurer, do you believe it's reasonable to know that the money that was stated is in the books is actually in the books? Is that a reasonable expectation?
I'd like to ask Brother Webb if he has contacted a lawyer or retained a lawyer or contacted a lawyer.
What's the purpose for that question?
Well, I just heard you that.
You did?
Yes.
Who told you that?
My wife. Now, I don't know who told her. I heard that last night.
You heard that from your wife?
From my wife.
Would you mind asking her what her source is?
No, I would.
Could you just answer that question?
I'm asking you. All you have to say is yes or no.
It's not reasonable for me to know who your source was.
Brother Cornelius?
I'm not getting my wife mixed up. I'm going to tell you that. And all you have to say is yes or no. Did you contact her?
No, I did not. No, I did not.
Okay.
Now could I ask the question of what your source was?
Forget it.
So you won't answer my question, but
I will not answer your question, no. I told you, my wife told me. I don't know where she got it. She didn't tell me. But I'm going to tell you something. I don't care if you got a lawyer. It worries me when people get lawyers in church problems. We're brothers. You've been my friend. First time we was in Florida, and I didn't tell all of you fellas here. We was in Florida. You said, where's your receipt for your room? And I said, I don't have one. You said, so we never did have to have one before. And you said, well, I'll try to get you money. You remember that? I said, you'll do more and try, you'll get my money.
No, I don't remember that at all.
I could see right then we're going to have a little problem. Brother Black, the elders have made moves that due to non-compliance to job responsibilities and to orders from the General Overseer, Finance Committee and Board of 12 elders, we move for the with General Secretary and Treasurer to be suspended from his office and duties with pay and all benefits until the 2004 assembly election. And the vote was majority of the judge.
All right.
That was two blanks.
All right, we thank you, brethren, for your work today. And we would like to ask Brother Webb to surrender the keys to the office and follow the direction of the elder board. All right. The elder board is blessed you, Brother Webb. Showed kindness, gentleness to you here to bless you with your salary, your benefits. More than likely, does that includes living in the Parsonage Jury Assembly and things. We'll ask you to follow the instructions and work with the elder board. Work with us, surrender your keys, vacate the office immediately.
I have no intention of hurting this assembly. This has been the fellowship of the brethren that I've worked with. One simple request from the Finance Committee Chairman: validate the numbers that I came into office for. Is that unreasonable, Brother Massengill? It's one thing for money to be missing. And then it's another thing totally for, you know, you not to be able to account for it. And then it's another thing totally to try to blame somebody else for it. Money is missing. It's not accounted for. It's up to $44,000 now. $44,000 that's unaccounted for in the benevolent fund. Why didn't you ever ask for the CDs and the checkbooks, the bank statements from the previous administration? Of your own admission, you didn't do that.
I told you that. Why we didn't? And then we all just delayed.
If things would have been done right in the beginning, we wouldn't be here. But they weren't done right. The meeting Tuesday week ago was adjourned. And we had a finance committee that refused to validate the numbers that I mean, if I were a finance committee person, I'd be more than willing to have a CPA come in and simply validate those numbers that I inherited. That's all I requested. Brother Landis said, we've never scrutinized a general secretary and treasurer like this before.
I brought my name up and verify that. We were elected this year. I and Michael and we selected our chairman at the back of the building before you were elected, because your election came after that. We met as a committee and said, we're going to get a CPA, we're going to talk to Alan Law, so he could train us on how to properly look at the book. We never did get that done. There was nothing scrutinizing you personally or nothing. It was an intent that we had, that we were going to try to improve our job. Always before, when we was the previous finance committee member, always we called the general secretary and said, where is it? If it was a penny, we said, where is this? And we always let him find it. We didn't find it. We said, put it in there, make it right. And they made it right for the day for them. And there's been times like that that we've done that with you. We went across the line and found out that the figures didn't add up with the total. But we didn't just turn it over to you. We went back ourselves and did a lot of that work and looking for it. And I personally thought we were doing you a favor in finding the fault.
So you guys weren't qualified to do the job. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, we were qualified to do what we did. We were not CPA. No. We were qualified to do what the delegation decided.
So you were going to, I mean, is part of auditing the books, show me the money? Did that ever occur to you? Show me the money. You say you've got so much money, then there should be something to substantiate it. Is that reasonable? If you say you've got X number of dollars, then there should be a way to substantiate that money. So there's no pending audit.
The audit is
going to
be pending. We go along. And also the information that you and the shareholders get from the land has started out talking to the hall, and it seems like there was other laws. There is not an end in audit at CPA.